All right, good morning. We have us a beginnings of our refrigerator compartment, which I will be squaring up, and then I'm going to cut my holes. I'm going to be installing an outlet on this wall before I put my skin on it, because over here is where the TV is going to mount. So when I determine where I'm going to mount that, I'm going to put some additional bracing in there to strengthen that up, and then I'm going to drop some electric down through here, and no big deal, but I want to make sure I do that before I close this up. All right, let me do that and I'll be back. Okay, I'm starting to cut my inside panels out. Got it marked. I've got it, my access panel ready to go. This was over a joint, so I have my right piece and my left piece, and I've got them marked. And what I'll do is, when I cut the left side, then I'll join those two pieces back together, stick it back in the hole, drill my holes, carry it outside, and do exactly what I did with my hot water tank. All right, I'll be back. Okay, I've got my inside hole cut, and I've got the two pieces. They're right here. That's my left, my right, and I drew a line. And when I match up that line and that line, and I'm going to put some Gorilla Tape on it right here, and I'll stick it back in the hole, and I'll drill two holes through that stud just like I did with the hot water tank, and they're going to pop out the other side. Then I'll unscrew it from in here, take it out there, stick it on, and we should be good to go. And I'll cut that out. I'll be back. All right, I've got the board that I cut out, put back in the hole, and now I'm going to drill my two holes through and put my screws in. Okay, I haven't screwed it to the trailer yet. I just kind of wanted to kind of demonstrate, show you how you do it. So since this was two separate boards, I had to Gorilla Tape them together. And put them back in the hole inside, drill my holes. Now this one I did three screws because I wanted to catch this board and that board. I mean, Gorilla Tape is great, but I didn't trust it to hold it perfect the way I wanted it. So I went ahead and put another screw in it, because we're going to be vibrating and hitting this thing with a saber saw here soon. All right, I'll be back. Let me cut this hole. Okay. It's all cut out. I wonder. I wonder if it's gonna fit. I'm videotaping. Here's Mama's. Look at that. Nice big hoe.
Hi, baby.
Here.
Are you patching up before it rains?
I'm gonna patch it up before it rains. Okay. Let me blow the shit out of here before it. Well, good afternoon, folks. Look what we have. We have a refrigerator access panel. I'm going to be putting another one up there tomorrow, and then I'm going to be putting one on the roof. I think in yesterday's video I mentioned that the venting of the refrigerator compartment was extremely important. Different reasons, And I've still got to do some bracing around that and everything, and I'll get to that. But let me clean up a little bit. Looks like we got some rain coming. And I'll be back and show you what's going on. Alright, this, that piece of metal I put down there underneath that is galvanized steel. Can it rust? I'm sure it can, and will it? It probably will, you know, in 20 years from now, but, I mean, it's a pretty heavy duty piece of steel. And it's just laying there, so, you know, not bad. But behind the refrigerator, I went with aluminum, okay? So I've got these 24-inch panels, and in the very back there is where my, is where the access panel is. So I've still got some, I've got some blocking I have to do in here, and I will, I got one screw in, but there'll be, you know, I'm going to build like a nice frame around there and set it in the hole. But anyway, you see the aluminum, so I have to cut that basically the same size as the hole, but what I'm gonna do is leave tabs that fold over, that'll fold over to the aluminum, and try to do the same thing at the top. And this way I can make use of that aluminum, and then there won't be any wood exposed. All right, let me looks like rain is getting ready to roll in here, and I've got quite the mess to clean up, so give me a few minutes and I'll come back and show you everything. I'm bringing the girl right at my feet. She's sleeping good. I love it. All right, well, there's my refrigerator access panel. It's got two screws in it right now, but and I just put some clear tape over because look, it's gonna rain. And there's the hot water tank. Ain't she beautiful? Still gotta hook the gas up and the electricity, but I'm not gonna do any of that stuff right now. When I do all my appliance connections, I'm gonna do them all in one day, all at once. Make my wire connections, electricity connections, and everything. So I don't have to worry about that right now. It's installed, it's in place, and it's where I want it. Looks good. My furnace vent, my refrigerator vent. Tomorrow I'm going to cut the upper one and then the roof one. So that'll be fun. And here's the piece that I cut out. It's pretty badass, huh? And because I'm a cheap bastard, I don't. I paid for these screws. So I'm gonna keep them. Okay. And there's gonna come a time where I'm gonna need 1 3-inch screw, and I can't find it, and I'm gonna have a flashback to when I threw it away. So, all right, let me get these tools inside. It does look like it's getting ready to open up. So, all right, I'll be back. All right. Everything's covered up. Trailer's all buttoned up. I'm just making sure the truck's locked up. Actually, I'm making sure the windows are up. Let's see what we got here. Nope. Now it's locked up. Trailer's looking good. Looking good. Black Betty and old White Betty. Okay, well, I feel like I got a lot done today. You know, planning that that refrigerator compartment was something. Let me tell you what. It's got to be solid. It's got to be airtight. And you know, I went overboard with the aluminum. I could have got away with some galvanized steel, but you never have to worry about it rusting. And where the refrigerator fits in that space, about 95% of the way back from the refrigerator, I'll be putting weather seal. So the fumes can't get around the edge of over and around the refrigerator, even though the refrigerator flange has weather, whatever you want to call it, foam. Just doesn't seem like that much. It's like an eighth of an inch thick. But I want something substantial, so got all my my hot water tank thermostat manuals. Got my CheapHeat controls, my heating coil. I've got my air conditioner heating coil. The one in the ceiling also has a heat strip in it. And that's the controls for that. And I still got all my plugs and everything. I just come in the house and grab them when I need them. All right, I'm gonna cut this day off. It's about 3 o'clock in the afternoon, been at it all day. And that's Patriot. Say hi, Patriot. All right, we'll see you guys tomorrow. Like the video if you think it's cool. If not, don't. Comments are always welcome. Thanks. Oh, real quick. This is what Mama does when she's not yelling at me. She's playing with her doll baby. She just bought all these today. So she's pretty happy about that. Hopefully the rain's gonna bring some pool water. Fill it up a little bit. Anyway, good night. Well, have a great night.